Philippine shares extend their gains for a second straight session, even as stricter curbs remain in Metro Manila. The main index up by 0.5% to close at 69.49. Sun Life Asset Management says foreigners were net sellers today by 50 million pesos. Among the top traded names were Ayala Land, Mondanisin, and PLDT. As value turnover remained thin, Corinne Agravia of Regina Capital says there was a lack of fundamental catalysts to move the market and expects this to continue until the end of the month.
Indecisive the market is at this point. The variables that we have to take into consideration now are only more volatile than ever. So at least until the end of the month, it's highly likely that value turnover will remain very anemic. And that's also because it would be safe to assume that investors are staying on the sidelines for now, staying more cash heavy. They're starting to become more cautious now since the index has gone up so much in the past 2 weeks, and everyone's just watching and waiting for a significant pullback. So at this point in time, it's likely that the anemic value turnover will continue for the rest of the month. Everyone is more focused on the spread of the Delta variant, of course, and how the government is dealing with the pandemic. And while the trade surplus would be, you know, telling of how the economy is moving or recovering during the pandemic, it's not that big enough of a catalyst.
Neither Agravio or Manny Ocampo of the Investment and Capital Corporation of the Philippines expect heavy trading to resume until October, when the third quarter ends.
The foreign funds, I think, continue to trade the market rather than invest and maybe stay in it for, you know, hopefully at least the medium term. But people, you know, the foreign funds are trading the market. So they'll take a look at opportunities, at least on the short term, to buy and, you know, take profit at maybe 5-10%. When we end the third quarter, I think people will be looking at third quarter earnings, which should pretty much set the trend up to the end of the year already. But as we move towards 2022, rain, no? the other factor will of course be the coming elections.
The services sector advanced the most for the day. Both analysts say with the continued quarantine measures in Metro Manila and other areas, the telco issues are expected to perform well. And down the line, investors will be watching for their updates on improved services and getting new subscribers. Rain Musngi, ABS-CBN News.